All right, well, this video is bound to come sooner or later. Wait, hold on a second. Hey, you guys, I never thought I'd have to make this video. But here we are. Okay, you sick bastards have been asking for this one for a really long time, so here you go. I hope you really enjoy me having to rehash all of these painful, deep, cutting memories. This video contains all of my beloved Holy Grail products that have been discontinued or reformulated. Some of them I have had the chance to stockpile, others, not quite as lucky. Some of these products are all but a memory, and I'll have to insert Google images because I was given so little notice that it was already too late. By the time I realized it was discontinued, it was gone forever from my hands. So I'm pretty pissed. If you're new to my channel, I have a horrific curse. I'm not sure who put some spooky bitch hex on me, but all my favorite shit gets discontinued. Maybe it's because I'm a visionary. Maybe it's because I'm too ahead of my time. I don't know. Here's all my favorite shit that's been discontinued. Here's all the brands that just absolutely despise me, because why else would they do this to my soul? Before we dive into this, I just want to let you guys know that some of these brands are not brands that I use anymore or support anymore, whatever. But it's part of my heartbreak. This is part of my truth. And I'm just gonna tell you the whole shebang. So one of the first products, this was a tragedy. I had been searching for the best bronzer, like just a really good powder bronzer that wasn't like too warm, too like orange or red kind of thing, like just a really, really, really good bronzer. And I had found this powder from Becca, and they used to have these like big powders, and now they're kind of in smaller packaging. And it was called Bamboo. And it was just like a face powder, but it was like, it was immaculate. And I literally found it, I loved it, I hit pan, I burned through an entire product, which like, as a beauty guru, that's hard. It's hard to like burn through actually like a full product because you're trying so much new shit, but like I used the absolute shit out of that, backwards, forwards, all which ways. I was loving on that bronzer so hard. And then, I went to repurchase it and I was having a really hard time finding it, and I got that feeling in my soul and I was like, this is bad, this could be bad. Lo and behold, I think I tweeted about it and I was like, is this happening to me? Is this happening to me right now? And Becca actually reached out to me and they were like, oh, unfortunately, yeah, we are like discontinuing it, but we're coming out with like some new bronzers we'd love to send you. And I was like, no, I don't want the new, send me Bamboo, send me all of your residual stock, please, for the love of God. And just like that, it was taken from my hands. I think I got the chance to find one more of those, so I actually got to have two of them. But I don't have it anymore. I've burned through that, it's gone. That was a painful one for me, because bronzer is one of those things that, I'm gonna have to move on. There's a long list to go through. Oh. Oh, my blood is literally boiling. This is the worst fucking video I've ever filmed in my life. Jamie Page. It's like, in these situations, I'm like, should I hate the person who introduced me more? Should I hate the brand? Should I hate myself? I don't know. I don't know where to direct my anger. So Jamie Page has a long history of recommending items to me, and a lot of the times I don't like her recommendations. I'm so sorry, Jamie. We just have like different tastes, I guess. And I kept telling her for the longest time, because she would like recommend to me like foundations and concealers and shit, and I was like, Jamie, okay, listen. Oh, I know you don't understand because you have like this really pure, fresh French Canadian skin. I don't have that. I am an acne scarred angel. I don't know what you don't understand about this. We can't use the same shit. She had been wanting me to try this Tom Ford concealer for like the longest time, and I was like, dude, I'm not buying that Tom Ford concealer. It was like $70 or something ridiculous like that in Canada. And she was like, Sam, trust me, like it's so good, you'll love it. Like it's just awesome, I love it so much, blah, blah, blah. And then we had taken like a girls trip to New York together, and she had that concealer there, and she was like, please just try it, like it's so good. And I was like, oh, fuck, fine, sure, I'll try it. I put that concealer on, the heavens parted. Jesus came down, reincarnate, in the form of Tom Ford concealer. Where do I begin? It was the color, first of all, the color was like just flawless. It was perfect. Like, it was the perfect color. It was like not too yellow, not too peachy, like just blended seamlessly. It was made for me specifically. They referenced my skin color when they were putting that into production. And just like the formula, like it was not too like heavy. It was just really nice and like light feeling, and it made your skin look so hydrated and like alive kind of thing. It made me feel alive. And I was like, Jamie, this is the best. This is the best product. And she was like, yes, yes. Cause like she was so excited that I finally liked one of her product recommendations. And I carried my merry ass to Sephora and I was like, give me that Tom Ford shit, let's do this. And it was the best. I had the best month of my life. I loved that concealer. I thought we were forever. I went in to pick up more and they were like, it's out of stock. And I was like, don't fucking blame you. Fantastic concealer. I'll wait my turn, no problem. Next month, out of stock. Month after that. Out of stock. And then one day I go in and I'm like, hey, kind of seems like you guys have been out of stock for an awfully long time. I almost get the feeling that you're going to discontinue this concealer. Would that be right? I just have a lot of experience with this. And they were like, oh no, no, like don't worry, we're not discontinuing. We're reformulating. The only words that are more horrific to my being then discontinued is reformulated, because I don't even get to experience a true loss. I have a shell of what I once loved. So here's the reformulated garbage. It's not that it's like that bad of a concealer. Like if I had tried this concealer originally, you're not gonna get anything from me holding up this. It probably wouldn't actually be that bad of a concealer for me if I had like never tried the original formula, but having tried that original formula and then trying this one, it's just like not the same. The color's a little bit off. This one tends to kind of get dark. I don't know if you guys will be able to see. Let me cover this sunlight here. But even if like you look around where like I kind of swatched it, it kind of is turning a little bit dark. You might not be able to really see it that much, but it's not the same. Like it doesn't blend out as seamlessly. Like the other one, you could literally just, it has this kind of like little felt tip thing and you could just kind of swipe it on and like literally be like boop boop. And it would just look like Pat McGrath had come to your home and applied your concealer on your behalf. And this one is not like that. I want my money back. And the best month of my life. YSL Touche Éclat Original Formula Foundation. Why you gotta do me like that, YSL? This foundation, first of all, was one of my first like high-end, like luxury kind of purchases. And I just remember like putting it on my skin and I looked in the mirror and I was like, is that my fucking skin? Like I was like this, I am Gigi Hadid. I hadn't thought that previously, but now I kind of am thinking that, and it's due to this foundation. It was just the most, like it looked like skin, like it looked like my skin. Like that's why it was so shocking to look in the mirror. It was one of the first foundations that I ever looked at and I was like, holy fuck, like my skin actually looks so good. Not even like, oh, that foundation looks good. No, my skin, this is me. Bitch, this is my skin. It just laid so beautifully on your skin. It looked so thin and like even and just nice on top of your skin. Like it didn't look like there was like visible foundation kind of thing. It was just beautiful. It was like perfectly like kind of more like medium coverage, like probably more sheer, buildable to medium. It's been so long I can barely remember what it sounds like anymore. It was phenomenal. It was such a good foundation. I loved it. The only downside to it was that it was, well, exorbitantly priced and also so scented. Like all of YSL stuff is like so, so, so scented. Same fucking thing. They reformulated. Oh, I was so mad. I can't even like really put, like with the Tom Ford one, I'm like, oh, this is what's different. With the YSL one, I cannot really put my finger on what's so different about it, but it's just not the same. That's all I have to say about that. Ugh. This one was upsetting. They all were. I don't know why I'm like prefacing every single product by saying that. Okay, so I really quite like blush a lot, but I don't wear it or buy it a ton because I'm very particular. And what I don't like about blush is that there's so many blushes on the market that are like hot pink and like magenta and like really coral and all this kind of shit. And it's like, okay, but also what about like a blush that like I don't have to think about that much, you know? Like I want a blush that's like just a little bit more chill. And this was just a blush that when I got it, I was like, yes, this is perfect. This is everything because it's so easy to put on. You don't have to think about it. It looks beautiful every time. Like there's no guesswork, you know what I mean? It's just perfect. Kat Von D Wish blush. So this was the second one that I had bought. I had actually gone through an entire package of this one as well. But this is what the blush looks like. It is like so simple and like barely there kind of thing. It has the tiniest, tiniest little bit of sheen to it. It's not glittery. It's not a shimmer. It's just like this really light little, just a drop of sheen. And it makes your skin look so glowy, so beautiful, but not like you have like highlighter on, because there's a lot of blushes now that have kind of like reflect to it, but it's too much. Like it looks like a pink highlighter basically. This was perfect. And it was a blush that like I literally never had to think about. I could just slap it on. It tied the whole look together. It didn't matter if I was wearing like a cool toned eye, a warm toned eye, like it did not matter. It looked perfect no matter what. I loved this blush. I raved about it. And then discontinued, you bitches. Blush shopping has never been the same since. Like I have such a hard time finding blushes I love. It's misery. And you guys will probably see that throughout my channel, because like I use a lot of the same blushes like over and over and over again, or I don't even mention blush at all because I've had my heart broken too many times. Anyways, I was pretty upset about that one. That one hit real, real hard. But I did have one of my lovely subscribers way back in the day, because this is old as balls. Like even just the packaging, like you can see this is like old school Kat Von D. Before she was like against the vaccines. I mean, she probably still felt that way, but she hadn't mentioned it to us yet. I had a subscriber of mine, so lovely. He, I can't remember if he worked for Sephora, if he just like, I think he did work for Sephora, and he was like, we have some like backups of Kat Von D Wish, like I'd love to send them to you. And he sent me 3. God bless you. Oh. I know I keep saying this, but this one cut real deep. I remember the lady that sold this to me. And I was watching her put this blush on someone else and she was like, this blush is so great. Like it's the perfect color. It's not too orange. It's not too pink, blah, blah, blah. And I watched her apply it on another person and I was like, dang, that blush is not too orange and not too pink. Looks real fucking good. And I was like, what is that shit? And she was like, Warm Soul, it's my favorite. And I was like, even the name, I knew it was love. Just like every part of that blush hit me. I was like, yes, this is for me to have. This is for me to have. And I bought that blush for years. We had a good long run. Like they really let me get super like disturbingly attached and then fucking cut the cord. Whatever. Let me just explain it to you. It's even in the original packaging. This is actually a mineralized blush from MAC. So this is the only one I have. I cherish it. I keep it on my desk so I can look at it all the time, but I don't use it very often. And when I do, I use it sparingly. I used to put this on like thick, like so much of it. Like I couldn't get enough Warm Soul. Like I wanted to be warmer than that. Hot. I wanted a hot soul burning up like the Jonas Brothers. That's what I wanted. I can't tell you how many people I've turned on to this blush. Like it, I just purchased and repurchased and repurchased. Like I probably have never repurchased and like burned through a product as much as I have this one. Like I could not even tell you how many of these blushes I've repurchased, because I used to wear, that's okay. It's getting worked up anyway, so.
Okay, what are you feeling?
All the products that I know and love that have been discontinued. Ugh. Fuck my life. And every time I hit pan on this, like the bottom of this looks like a waffle kind of thing. And every time I hit pan, I'd be like, no. Like I just would be so sad about it. Cause for a lot of the years while this was still available, I was so broke. So I really had to save up to like, I had to plan and like save up to repurchase Warm Soul, because I could not let there be, like there was no room for there to be a gap, like no funny business. I was not going to go a singular day without this blush. So I would have to like pre-plan for how I was gonna save up to afford it. So there's Kat Von D, there's MAC Warm Soul. MAC Warm Soul is like golden hour in a blush. Like it is, ugh, like it's just, it's this most beautiful, like warm, rosy kind of like peach bronze. Like it's just so stunning. And this blush is beautiful across so many skin tones. Like, it just is absolutely stunning. Like, no matter, like, you could be feeling like absolute shit, you'll put that on and be like, I'm fucking A1, baby. Like, it made you look so youthful, so beautiful, so glowy and bronzy. Like, it was perfect. And kind of a similar thing, it has a little bit of a sheen to it. It's a little bit more intense than the Kat Von D one. I don't know why I'm explaining this as if, like, you're gonna choose between the two, because you fucking can't, because they're not available. But it had a little bit more of a sheen than that Kat Von D one. But the big thing is that it was not glittery. Now, a lot of you are probably like, but Sam, Warm Soul is still at MAC. Not my Warm Soul. Not my fucking Warm Soul. Yes, they do still have it. So this is the original. This is the... I'm going to show you the swatch. And you're going to be like, this looks very similar. I don't care if you think I'm crazy. I know there's a difference. This is not my child. And a mother knows. This is the original. This is the reformulated version. So the reformulated version is a lot more golden. It has a lot more of that kind of yellow golden sheen to it, and it also is glittery. I did a collaboration with MAC a couple years ago, and we made a lipstick together, and I got to go into their lab, and while I was there, they were like, oh yeah, this is like all the people that like make the makeup. And I was like, okay, so who can I talk to about Warm Soul? And they were like, huh? And I was like, I need to talk to the senior most person here. And they ended up introducing me to one of their like chemists. And I was like, what happened and why? I need a full report. And I was like, why did you guys change Warm Soul? It was perfect. It was beautiful. And they were like, did we? And I was like, yep. Yeah, you did. And they were like, oh, did we? I didn't know. And they were like, we'll look into it. Like, we'll figure out what happened. And I was like, okay. I eventually heard back from them like months later, and they were like, turns out like we didn't actually like change anything. And I'm like, oh, so you're liars is what's going on then. They swear they didn't change this formula. But I've always noticed a difference. It's never been the same. So I was like, okay, maybe like I just got one that was like oddly glittery for some reason. And I did end up repurchasing a second one just to like double check. Nah, dude. This product is perfect. So this is the Cover FX Custom Enhancer Bronzing Drops, and this is in the shade Sunkissed. If you've been on my channel for a while, you would have heard me talk about this like a million times. It comes in like the same little dropper formula as all their other stuff, but this, god damn it. The color is just absolutely perfect for my skin tone. It's got almost like this little bit of like a cool tone kind of pull to it. It looks kind of like super orange when you first look at it kind of thing, but it does have, it's almost like a, I don't want to say this because I feel like this will scare you off, but you can't buy it anyways. It's almost like this silvery kind of shift to it that makes it look kind of cool toned, because it is tan. It is my tan. Like, it is not super orangey or red or anything like that. It is just honestly like the perfect tone. It's gorgeous. It has a little bit of a sheen to it, so it makes your skin look really, really beautiful, but it's definitely not, again, something where it's like, it looks like a like bronzed highlighter kind of thing. It's definitely like a true bronzer, but it has that kind of sheen that just makes it look really beautiful and skin-like. And that was another bronzer that like, I used that a ton, especially when I had like really, really bad acne, because it didn't matter. Like, there were certain products, and especially powder products, that if I put it on over top of my acne and like textured skin, it just wasn't a good look, and it would make me feel really self-conscious, and it would make it look even more textured. That was a bronzer that like every single time I put on, I was like, fuck yeah, dude. Like, I felt so much better about my skin. I never felt like it looked over the top or like I could over apply it too easily or anything like that. Like, it always looked really, really nice. And they discontinued it, and I have no idea why, because to me, I feel like they don't have a ton of that in their range, and it just worked so beautifully with their like highlighter drops and stuff that I'm like, why not? It's fit fine with everything. It was great. What's the problem? I did have a friend that somehow, I have no idea how, she probably had to bust a few kneecaps for this, but she did track down 2 extra bottles of that, like months after it was discontinued. And so I do have 2 extra bottles hoarded, and I'm keeping that ship life. Magnifique, first chef's kiss of the entire video. Oh, The foundations are the worst. The foundations are the worst. Estee Lauder Cushion Stick Foundation. I bought quite a few of these as well. Like, I had repurchased this quite a few times. I have this little amount left, and I want to use it so bad. And I know it's going bad, but I can't. I can't bring myself to use the last little bit because I want to keep it so badly, just for a special occasion or something. I don't know, but it's perfect. It just was another one of those products that, like, it just made my skin look so good, and it didn't matter what I was dealing with because I've gone through all these spurts of acne and shit like that. Like, it always made me feel good. It always made me feel super confident. It's like really, really like radiant and like glowing and beautiful. It's a little bit more full coverage than I wear these days, but I don't care. Estee Lauder, please. We could be together. I can change. So I had been in Sephora and I was swatching these eyeshadows from Kat Von D and I was like, dang, these are really nice. And then I swatched this one called Thunderstruck. When I swatched it, I was like, that kind of seems like that'd be like a really nice highlighter. So that is Thunderstruck right there. It has this beautiful like gold and pink shift to it, but it's not something like, you know, everyone's been coming out with these highlighters that are like colored highlighters, like really pink, really frosty purple, really frosty blue, stuff like that. It's not like that. It's like the slightest pink shift ever, like so like gently pink shift kind of thing, and gentle kind of gold as well. It's just a gentle product. It's the slightest shift that just makes it look so beautiful on your skin. Like, it kind of just like, I can't even describe to you, it's like that pink and that gold are just so slight that your skin and those tones are just like this. It looks really beautiful on the skin. It's not super chunky. The formula is like really nice and smooth and beautiful. It doesn't look really thick on your skin, even though it is like a pretty like blinding highlight in comparison to what I wear now. And then it was gone. Oh my god, I wish I had backups of this, but also they'd be so expired, so maybe not. Bite. Like, Canadian to Canadian. How dare you? Bite used to have these lip glosses called Lush Fruit Lip Glosses. They were simply divine. They had this really beautiful kind of like sheerness to it. Like, it wasn't a full pigment gloss by any means, but it wasn't so sheer that it like looked like nothing on the lips like a lot of products that I use now. They were so comfortable on the lips. They were so like soft and like pillowy and cushiony and majestic. I loved them. They smelled great. They felt great. They looked great. They were why? And not even with anything to replace it. You ripped the rug out from right underneath me. And you didn't even slip in a replacement goldfish, you dirty dogs. I was so upset about that. I still am. And that was one of the products that, like, I hadn't had, this was years ago, I really haven't let it go. I hadn't really had that much heartbreak. Like, I had had MAC Warm Soul happen for sure. I know that had already happened. And I think, like, a couple other products had, like, been discontinued, but it hadn't happened so many times that, like, I could smell it, you know? Like, it was one of those products where I was like, huh. I haven't seen those in a while. Maybe they just sell them online. I don't know. I didn't even really think about it at first. I was just kind of like, whatever. I was just going about my merry way using my own at home. And then I went in to repurchase a color once. And the Sephora employee was like, oh, they discontinued those months ago. And I was like, but why would they do that? And she was like, I don't know. You crazy bitch, get off the property. I was robbed blind in the middle of the night. My lip gloss collection will never be the same. Ugh, Alana. This really made me question our friendship for sure. Alana, ugh, what a fucking animal. Alana recommended a product to me that was already discontinued. Why would you do this? Why would you ever put me in that position? But she done did it, and I done bought it, and I like it, and I don't know what to do with myself. So Alana has this, like, she just looks like a model. It's really, really hurtful. I don't like spending time with her because of it. But she was wearing this nice, like, little, like, smoky, like, Kendall Jenner eye situation. And I was like, what the fuck is that on your lid? And she was like, Dior Fusion Mono Eyeshadow and Meteor. I searched high and low for that shit. Finally found it at the Sephora. And I was like, must be out of stock because it's super popular because Alana must talk about it all the time. No. It was already gone. It was already discontinued. I got one. I do have backups of this one as well, actually. Just look at it. It's like the most, it's perfect. Like, it's not so glittery and textured and chunky that, like, you have to do, like, a whole fucking look with it kind of thing. You could totally just, like, slap this, like, right on your lid with nothing else and kind of blend it out, because the more that you blend it out, the less kind of, like, intensity and shimmer it has, and it kind of just has this really nice, like, sheer kind of, like, shine to it. Such, like, red carpet glam kind of, like, look. It's beautiful. It's stunning. It's really pretty on its own. It's really pretty just with, like, one kind of color washed all over the lid and blended out, and not just like kind of down the center sort of thing. And it's discontinued. This is barely a beauty product, but I'm still gonna bring it up because it still hurts so bad. Lush Cosmetics. They had this bath bomb called Phoenix Rising. I'm not gonna harp on this for too long. It smelled like apple cinnamon delight, okay? It was the best smell ever. Like, you put it in and you were like, it is Christmas. It was so comforting and like just beautiful, and like you'd go to bed and you'd smell like just a hot apple tart. Like, it was the nicest thing ever. So, so nice. And then they fucking discontinued it. Why? And now then suddenly they release 50 bath bombs, because at the time they were like, well, you know, we discontinued to make room for other things, and they didn't make room for anything. They didn't add anything after they discontinued it, and then suddenly they come up with 50 new bath bombs like 3 years later, and I'm like, 50? No apple cinnamon scent? I did have a friend that worked for Lush at a time, and she did bring me literally an entire box of Phoenix Rising bath bombs, and I'm still working through them to this day. That was literally years ago. They were also very expired. They barely fizzle anymore. Like, when you put them in the bathtub, they're literally like, there's like no fizz left of them. They're just like, oh, this was one of the OG heartbreaks. Ugh, sweet summer child. There was a time where I wasn't really into skincare. Now it's like, I buy it like it's freaking going out of style, because like, I just think it's a fun time. And I love when I find like a skincare product that I'm like, yes, this. Like, this just makes me feel and look so good. Like, this is so beautiful. One of the first skincare products that I ever tried, where I was like, okay, I get it. Like, I get why people actually spend the time to like, do nice things to their skin. I was young, okay? I didn't understand the ways of the world yet. I didn't know I had like an acne storm coming. One of the first real skincare products I bought was Josie Maran Argan Milk. Everything about that was perfect. Like, the bottle, the scent, the dropper, the feel of it, the way it made your skin look, like, I cannot even describe. You would put that on at night, you would wake up the next morning and be like, a glowing angel? No, it's me. This was a product that I bought over and over and over again. And then I kind of started like, you know, buying other skincare and stuff like that. And I strayed a little bit. I strayed from it. You don't know what you got until it's gone, man. I loved it. There was nothing wrong with it. There was no reason why I stopped purchasing it. It was just something where I was like, oh yeah, I'm gonna try this other shit now. And I ended up kind of trying some other things for a little while. And I eventually came back around. I circled back to the Josie Maran Argan Milk. And the packaging was different. Weird, but whatever. Maybe they just wanted to change it up a little bit. And then I brought it home to my humble abode, and I squirted it into my little hand, my little outreached palms, and it was white. And I was like, that's not right. Because originally the argan milk looked suspiciously and alarmingly like semen. It was odd. I'm not gonna lie to you. The first time I used it, I was like, is it? Could be. Am I upset about it? Not particularly, because it's doing some real wonders for my skin, so I'll take it. And I pumped this thing out, and this thing was pure white. Reformulated. That's what I get. That's what I get for stepping away. I didn't know that was gonna happen. I would not have stopped purchasing it if I had. I would have spent every last moment that I could together. But I left. I was the one to walk away, and it's my fault. I'm so upset about this still, and they swear, same thing. They're like, we didn't change the formula, like, we just like repackaged it, and like, I can't remember, like, but I'm like, but why is it white and not semen then? It's not the same anymore. It doesn't do the same shit for my skin. It's not as like mind-blowingly good. It's like, it's nice and it feels really nice on the skin, and I still don't mind it, but it's not what it was.
Why are you
still filming? Alyssa, I have a lot of really discontinued products here, okay?
What?
I have one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, Jesus. 18, 19. 19 products total. You would think that after all of this, that I would be used to it. No, doesn't get easier. Writing down that list was hard. Filming it was worse. Editing it will be the real knife in the back. I hate you all for making me do this. How dare you? To the brands, who do you think you are? To everyone else that I've recently declared love for, if you leave me, I will find you and I will kill you. I'd rather take your life myself than have it taken from me. I need to end this video now. All right, you guys, that was really, really painful for me to film. Thanks so much for hanging out and watching. I will see you guys next time. Peace out.